This is Adi Sharma Solution, Class 11, Chapter 29, Limits, Exercises 29.10. Now, in this, we have variety of questions and we are going to use the evaluation of exponential and logarithmic limits here. So, there are around 43 questions, the addition which I have. It will take a while and you know, these formulas and identities, we just need to know so that we are able to solve these questions easily. And I'll tell you as and when required. First is under root this 5 to the power x minus 1 by under root 4 plus x minus 2. So wherever this comes, we will multiply it by RF. What is RF? Rationalization factor. So let us multiply it by RF. To take this 5 raise x minus 1 under root 4 plus x minus 2, multiply numerator denominator by plus sign of this, under root 4 plus x plus 2, here also under root 4 plus x plus 2. The denominator, you have a plus b, a minus b, so a square minus b square, a squared minus b square, so it will be 4 plus x. I am showing you the denominator right now. We have 4 plus x and minus 2 square is 4. Okay, now numerator we have extra this 4 plus x which we have introduced in RF. Then this is 5 raised x minus 1, 4 gets cancelled. So this only just witness this one. 5 to the power x minus 1 by x. Now if you assume 5 to be a raised x minus 1 by a. What does it mean? Limit x tends to 0. So limit is extending to 0. So if I apply limit x tends to 0, a raise x minus 1 by x is already, we have already seen this. This is equal to log a. Base is e. So log a. So just put log a. A is what? 5 here. So log 5 is there. Now I am applying the limit. X is 0. So under root 4 is 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. So 4 log 5. You can also write it as 4 log 5 or log 5 raised 4. That is 5 to the power 4. Also this you can write. So 4 log 5 is okay. Next is question number 2. Limit x tends to 0. Log 1 plus x by 3 raised x minus 1. So log 1 plus x and let us have a x here. When we have a x, we need to have x in the numerator. So we are not going to do that. Why? Because we also need a x here. 3 raised x minus 1 by x. So see, x and x gets cancelled. So it's okay. So this x gets cancelled. So it is of the same form, which is the question is saying. Limit is x tending to 0. Okay, this log 1 plus x by x is 1. And a raise x minus 1 by x is also 1. So this is 1. This, oh sorry, 3 raise x minus 1 by 3 is 3. Log 3. Log e base a, that is a is 3. Log 3 will come. Third is a raise x, a raise minus x minus 2. Limit is extending to 0. And x square. So there are certain things which you need to understand here. We'll try to make it in the form of a to the power x minus 1 by x. So how to do this? So if I just write a to the power x raised to the power x by 2, and if I square it, what do you get? A raise x by 2 into 2, and 2 gets cancelled. So it is a raise x. So a raise x, we can always write this as a to the power x by 2 raise 2. Same thing, a to the power x only. And so what is the benefit of this? Just I am going to tell you. First let us see a to the power minus x. Same thing we are going to do. If you replace x by minus x, same thing. A raise minus x by 2 to the power 2. Same thing is going to come. A raise minus x and minus 2. So a raise x by 2 and a raise x by 2 minus x by 2. What is going to be? So a raise x by 2 minus x by 2, that is a to the power 0. A to the power 0 is 1. So just assume it to be 2 into 1. In place of 1, I am writing a raise x by 2 and a raise x minus x by 2, same thing. So this is let us say it is p. So p square, p is a raise x by 2, q is a raise minus x by 2, this is q, this is minus 2 p into q. What is this? P minus q whole square. P is a raise x by 2 and q is a raise x minus x by 2. So a raise x by 2, a raise minus x by 2 whole square, this is p minus q whole square. What is denominator? X square, right? Now how can we write this one? The numerator I am going to tell you. A raise x by 2 and minus a raise x minus x by 2 can be written as 1 by a raise x by 2. And this can be, just multiply this, a into x by 2, a into x by 2, x by 2 plus x by 2 is 2x by 2, that is going to a to the power x minus, this goes 1, and in denominator you have a raise x by 2. And since it's all in square, okay, and denominator you already have a x square, this whole is in square, this is square, and denominator is also square, and x square is already there, x square is already there. So now this one, now just remember, just take this, a raise x minus 1 by x whole square, okay, I'm taking this one, a raise x minus 1 by x, this is limit x tends to 0, what it is going to be, it is log a, this is log a. What about this denominator? You already have this a x by 2 square, so x by 2, 0, first of all it is 2 by 2 to cancel and x is 0, so a raise 0 is 1. Here is x is 0, so 1 by log a, and since it is in square, square will come. This is the final answer. Question number 4. A raise mx minus 1, b raise nx minus 1, and we will use numerator and denominator separately and try to put the formula. So a raise mx minus 1 minus 1, mx multiply mx divide. Denominator you have b nx minus 1, numerator nx and denominator nx. Okay, right. So this is what? Apply limit here, limit x tends to 0. This is going to be, it's going to be log a base e a. What is this going to be? Since it's somewhat inverted, it is inverted. B to the power nx minus 1 by nx, you can always write this. Nx you can take in the denominator because it is same as nx in the numerator. So I'm taking this nx in the denominator, applying the limit. Same thing, log b here. Okay, a to the power x minus 1 by x is log a, so here log b. This we have already used. Mx by nx, xx gets cancelled, m by n will come. Only m by n will come. And this is m by n log a by log b, base is going to be e. Question number 5. A raise x plus b raise x minus 2. Okay, so minus 2 is already there. So take this minus 2, you can write it as minus 1 minus 1. So a raise x minus 1 and b raise x minus 1, and this x you can take separately also, x here and x here, it's one and the same thing. Now you can apply the limit, taking this one. Now apply the limits, limit x tends to 0. So a raise x minus 1 by x log a, b raise x minus 1 log b, base is e. And what is log a plus log b? It is log a into b. It's log a into b, log a plus log b, log a b, log a b will come. Now this is question number 6. Now 9 raise x minus 2 dot 6 raise x plus 4 raise x by x square. So we know this. So what we are going to write is 9, we are going to write it as 3 square. And 4 we are going to write it as 2 square, and 6 we are going to write it as 2 into 3. So 9 I am writing as 3 square raise x minus 2 into 6 raise x, we are writing it as 3 into 2 raise x And then finally 4x, I'm writing 2 square raise x. Okay. So x to the power 8 raised to the power b, you can write it as x to the power b raised a. You can always write like this. So this is 3 raised x to the power 2. I'm just changing it. And this is this. I'm taking this as the second term. 2 to the power x to the power 2. Here we have 3x and 2x. 3 raised x, 2 raised x to the power. A dot p to the power x is a raise x, b raise x. Now numerator, I'm just taking numerator, denominator will take later. So this is pq minus 2pq, p square plus q square minus 2pq. What is p here? 3 raise x, q is what? 2 raise x. So it is a minus b whole square. So 3 raise x minus 2 raise x whole square. This is whole square. And I'm introducing, because we have x square in the denominator. So we will use what? X square is already there. Now what we'll do? 3 raise x, you can take common, or you can introduce 2 raise x by yourself. So 2 raise x whole square, 2 raise x whole square, numerator denominator. Okay. So now this first term, 3 raise x minus 2 raise x by 2 raise x whole square, it is 3 raise x minus 2 raise x by 2 raise x. This is whole square. So now you can take this separately, means they divide the denominator by each term. So I'm going to take the next term later. So this is first term I'm taking, 3 raise x by 2 raise x minus 2 raise x, 2 raise x going to be 1 whole square. So this is 3 by 2 raise x minus 1, because this is going to be 1, because 2 raise x is 1, and this is whole square, it's going to be whole square. But if you see here, we already have a x square here. We already have a x square. Let us utilize it here. So 2 x square is already there. So a power x, x square we have utilized, and 2 to the power x whole square is already there. So if you take whole square, it is. So 3 raised x, 3, this is a to the power x minus 1 by x. So a raised x minus 1 by x is log a. What is log a? Is 3 by 2. So log 3 by 2 will come. Log 3 by 2 whole square, and 2 to the power x to the power whole square, x is 0, so 2 to the power 0 is 1, so 2 to the power x whole square, this 2 to the power, this already you utilized, this also you utilized, 2 raise x to whole square, 2 to the power x is applying 0, 2 to the power 0, anything to the power 0 is 1 already, so only log 3 by 2 whole square is going to come, 1 square, 2, that will be not affecting it, log 3 by 2 whole square is going to be your answer. Next question is question number 7. So these all are seen in the power of 2. So 8 we are going to write as 2 cube, 2 into 2 into 2. 4 can be written as 2 square, 2 into 2. And then we have 2, 2 raised to power 1 is 2. So you have to remember that a to the power b to the power say d. This is equal to a to the power d to the power b. You can interchange it. It's one and the same thing. So 8 we are writing as 2 cube to the power x, and then we have minus 2 square to the power x minus 2 to the power x plus 1. So denominator we have x square. Let us do this numerator first. So x and 3 will interchange. So 2 to the power x to the power 3 minus 2 to the power x to the power 2, 2 to the power x plus 1. Numerator we are taking. So 2 raise x, 2 raise x, you can take common, 2 raise x square. So 2 raise x square we are taking common. So it will be 2 raise x minus only 1 will remain. And minus 2 raise 1 I am taking common, minus 1. 2 raise x and minus 1 will come inside. Now 2 raise x minus 1 you can take common. 2 raise x minus 1 common. So 2 raise x minus 1. And you have 2 raise x whole square, or you can write it as 2 square to the power x. In either way you can write it like this. 2 to the power 2x or 2 to the power x square, you can write like this. and there is minus 1 also. So minus 1, two factors we have got. So 2 raised x, we had x square in the denominator. So you have x, take 1x, take 1x. So you have 2 to the power 2x minus 1 here. This is 2 to the power 2x minus 1. Now this is a to the power x minus 1 by x. And this is a to the power x minus 1 by 2x. So 2 to the power 2x minus 1 by 2x. So you have to multiply numerator denominator by 2. Okay, limit now. X tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0. So a to raise x minus 1 by x. Limit x tends to 0. This is going to be log a. This is log a. So log 2. And what about this? Log again, because 2x, 2x is equivalent to x. So again log 2. And then you have a 2 here. So you can take 2 here, and you know that the front of log can be taken as power. So a log b is equivalent to log b to the power a. It's one and the same thing. So log 2, you can take 2 as a power here. Log 2 square into log 2. So log 2 square is 4. So log 4. And here log 2. So log 4, log 2. This is your answer. Next question. This is a raise mx minus b raise nx by x. So we will introduce a minus 1 and a plus 1 by ourselves. That is a raise mx and minus 1. Then you have minus b raise x mx nx plus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 we have already introduced by ourselves. Denominator you have x already. So we will take x separately. That is amx minus 1 and b. I have taken minus common from the last two terms. And x can be in the denominator separately. You can take. So now apply the limit. So limit x tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0. So a raise mx minus 1 by x. So m you need in the denominator, m in the numerator. Here also you have n. So n in the denominator, n in the numerator. So now you can apply the limit here. So a raise mx minus 1 by mx. Then that is going to be, m was already there. So log a. And n is already there. So b raise nx minus 1 by nx is going to be log b. Is going to be log b. Now you, as we have just seen in the previous question, m can be taken here. A to the a raise m and also b raise n. So log a raise m minus log b raise n. And we know that log x minus log y is what? Log x by y. Log x by y. So here you can write log a raise m and log b raise n. So log a raise m by b raise n. So this is your answer. So log properties you need to know before solving, because all the questions which are coming have lot of logs questions. Now question number 9 here. So a raise n, b raise n, c raise n and minus 3. So minus 3 we will write it as minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So minus 3 we will write it as minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. That is minus 3. 1 we will take separately with one each of these. So a raise n minus 1 and this is one of the term plus b raise n, again minus 1 we are taking from minus 3, and then we have c raise n, c raise x it is. Everything is x, no n. C raise x minus 1. And since we have x in the denominator, we can take the x denominator separately. That is a raise x minus 1 by x, b raise x minus 1 by x, and c raise x minus 1 by x. So what is this term? A to the power x minus 1 by x, b raise x minus 1 by x, c raise x minus 1 by x. Now apply the limit. So when we apply the limit, it will be simply same thing, a raise x minus 1 by x. And that is going to be what? It's log a. I am applying the limit here. Second one will be log b. Third will be log c. So log a plus this whole will be log b, because b raise x minus 1 by x, log b, and this is log c. So a b log a plus log b plus log c. So log, you know, log x plus log y is what? Log x into y. Log x plus log y is log x y. So you can just take this log and a into b into c. A into B into C. So this is the final answer. Question number 10 here. You have x minus 2 by log A. Now see, the base is given properly. A here. It's mentioned. And we are only dealing with log base E. So we have to convert it. So x tends to 2 is there. First of all, we'll take the right hand limit. So we are putting x as 2 plus h. X as 2 plus h. When we take x as 2 plus h, what are you going to get? And h is tending to 0. So I'm putting x as 2 plus h. So 2 plus h minus 2. Base is a. Okay, log base is a. 2 plus h and minus 1. Minus 1. Okay. So if you see this log, x is the base and y, log y with base is x. So how can you write it as? Log y by log x with base e. You can have like this. Okay, y, log y by log x, and you can have base e. That is what we are going to do in the denominator. In the denominator, you are going to do that. So 2 plus h minus 2, you can get this 2 cancel, h by, and since base a is here, let us do this 2 plus h minus 1 first. So 2 plus h minus 1 will be what? 1 plus h, log 1 plus, means 1 plus h. So log base is a, this whole is 1 plus h, 1 plus h. So 1 plus h, base is e, 1 plus h. Now when the base is e, you can have log a in the denominator. Log 1 plus h, log a will go up with the base e. Okay, this is constant. Log a with base e is constant. This is h by log. Now you don't have to write e again because the log is base e. Now you can apply the limit. You cannot apply limit in the given question, but after changing it into e, you can apply. So log 1 plus x by x, x tends to 0 is 1. This whole will be 1. And this is log a already. You don't have to write base again and again. So this is only log a into 1. Log a will be the final answer. Question number 11. 5 raise x, 3 raise x, 2 raise x, minus 3. Same question. So minus 3 we are going to take minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 with each of the first 3 terms. So 5x minus 1 and then 3 raise x minus 1, x minus 1, then 2 raise x minus 1, 2 raise x minus 1 and x in the denominator. Here we have x here, x here, x here. We have plus, plus. Now you apply limit x tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0, okay. So when you have limit, a raise x minus 1 by x, that is log 5. Here you have log 3, here you have log 2. So 5 into 3 into 2, because the inside material of log will multiply if you have an addition in between them. So log 30, 5 into 3 into 2 is log 30, base is e. Now question number 12. So here x is tending to infinity. And we know that a raise x minus 1 by x can only be applied when we have limit tending to 0. So we need some replacement. So x is tending to infinity. So let us take, we have to replace 1 by x by y. So if we take y as 1 by x and x is tending to infinity, so 1 by infinity is what? 0. So y is tending to 0. So this will be a, 1 by x is y minus 1. So what is this x? X is 1 by y. So put it as 1 by y. So it will be a raise y minus 1 by y. The limit is now changed. Y is tending to 0. And this is a formula. A y minus 1 by y is log a. So this is going to be log a. Base is e. Now question number 13. A raise mx minus b raise nx by sine kx. So we can see that we have three different formula we can apply. That is a mx minus 1, then here minus b nx, and I'm adding, subtracting 1 and adding 1. 1 get cancel. So Now let us do numerator first. We have, do we have a x here? We don't have a x, but we need a x for sin kx. So we'll divide this whole by x by ourselves. A to x, mx minus 1, and minus, I'm taking minus common, b nx minus 1. Now I'm dividing it by x by ourselves. So sin kx already need x, so sin kx by x. So we have to have x because x will get cancelled. X gets cancelled. Okay. So now this, what is the fayda? What is the benefit? You can have k in the denominator, k in the numerator for the denominator. So now separate the numerator. It is amx minus 1 by x minus b raise nx minus 1 by x. And since we have a x here, so we need to have a n here, multiply, divide by n. Here we have m, so we need to have a m. So m here. So now applying the limit x tends to 0, same limit x tends to 0 will be applied here. Here also k is outside. So sin kx by kx, sin kx by kx. Okay, sin kx by kx is sin theta by theta, limit theta tends to 0 is 1. So this whole is going to be 1. Only k will remain in the denominator. So you can take it separately 1 by k as. How about the numerator? M is outside because it is a constant. A raise mx minus 1 by mx. What are you going to get? It is going to be log m, log a minus, here you have n outside because it is a constant. So b raise nx minus 1 by nx is what? Log b, same way as first one, log b. So now you can take the power m with a and power n with b. So log a raise m minus log b raise n, log b raise n, and you have k here, k. So k you can take outside. Now like log x minus log y is what? Log x by y. So you can write it as log a raise m by b raise n, and k is already there, 1 by k. This is going to be your final answer. Okay. So now the next one is question number 14. A raise x plus b raise x minus c raise x minus d raise x by x. So we will introduce 2 plus and 2 minus. A raise x minus 1 and b raise x minus 1. 2 minus 1, so we need to have 2 plus 1 also. So minus c n, c raise n, add 1 here. With d minus d raise n, you can have a plus 1 here also, plus 1. So why did we do this? X is already there, so just take x denominator with every term. x, okay. So we can always do that, x with each term. This will be a raise x minus 1 by x, b raise x minus 1 by x. Now I am taking minus common. So c raise x minus 1 by x, here also minus. So you have d raise x, all are x, d raise x minus 1 by x. Again, apply the limits. Everything is a raise x minus 1 by x. This is limit extending to 0. So all limit extending to 0, this is log a. This is log a plus log b. Here you have minus log c. Here you have minus log d. Okay. So now you can take minus common from here and it will be plus inside. So log a plus log b is log a into b, as you have seen earlier. Here log c plus log d, log cd as earlier. And log c minus log x minus log y is log x by y. So log ab by log ab by cd. So this, you know, you have to have a know the property of this, you know, log to solve these questions. Next question 15. So we have ex minus 1 by plus sin x by x. So this is, you know, simple two terms which we see, and they will made a formula. So we are taking x separately with, because same denominator, with these two. E raise x minus 1 by x, we have already seen this. This is going to be 1. And limit x tends to 0. Sin x by x is also 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 is going to be the answer. So this 16, sin 2x by e raise x minus 1. So sin 2x is there. So you can have a 2x in the denominator. You have to have a 2x. So when you have 2x, you have to have a 2x in the numerator also. We'll not do that. We'll just have a x, and this e raise x minus 1. So we can have a x also here. So this xx gets cancelled. So you have 2 here. So you have to have a 2 here, as I put it earlier also. So 2 multiply also. Now apply the limit. So sin 2x by sin theta by theta is going to be 1. And here also e raise x minus 1 by x is 1. So only 2 is remaining, which is the numerator. So 2 by 1 is 2. This is 2 as the answer. This is question number 17. E raise sin x minus 1 by x. What we will do? E raise sin x minus 1 by sin x, because we want to make it as e raise to x minus 1 by x form. So I am putting sin x here. So e to the power x minus 1 by x form it will be. So sin x, as we have to multiply sin x here also, because we have ourselves included the sin x. X is already there in the denominator. So let us apply the limit here. Since limit x is tending to 0, and when it is x is tending to 0, this sin 0 is what? X is tending to 0, sin 0 is 0. So what you can do is, you can take y as sin x. When you can have y as sin x, when x is tending to 0, sin 0 is 0. So y is tending to what? It is also 0. So we'll change the limit. Limit y tends to 0. And in the place of sin x, we are putting y, because we have replaced y by sin x. So sin x by x can be like this only. It will be same. So we have this sin x by x. Here we will keep x only. We will not replace it. Sin x, because these two are different terms, we can do it independently. So this will be 1, and this is also 1. According to the formula we have seen, 1 will be the answer. Now e raised to 2x minus e raised to x sin 2x. So this e raised 2x, so we can take e raised x common. So e raised x inside, and then you have inside 1. So e raise x you have taken common, and you have sin 2x. We will take it separately. So sin 2x, you need to have a 2x in the numerator. So 2x you read here also. And x. So 2x. 2 I have taken outside. And see, this e to the power x by 2, we will take it separately outside. And limit x tends to 0. We have e raise x minus 1 by x. And then we have limit x tends to 0, and sin theta by theta form. So sin 2x by 2x inverted. So this is going to be 1. This is also going to be 1. So e to the power x by 2 will remain. So this is 1. This whole is 1. This whole is 1. E to the power 0. Now applying limit. E to the power 0 by 2. So 1 by 2 it will be. Question number 19. So you have log x minus log a by x minus a. So log p minus log q is what? It's going to be log p by q. It's going to be log p by q. So we have log x by a, and this is x by a. That is x minus a. So we will try to formulate in the form of x by a. So you can take x common, rather you can take a common, it will be better. Why? Why? Because if we take a common, x by a will come. Otherwise it will be a by x, which you don't want. So you have a and x by a minus 1, a you have taken common. So a you can take separately as a denominator. Now it's still not forming. So you need x by a minus 1. For that you can add 1 and subtract 1 by yourself. So when you do this, a log. Now this is 1 I am taking here. Then I am writing x by a plus x by a minus 1 here. Since we have x by a minus 1 in the denominator as well. See, this is x by a minus 1. a is there already, 1 by a is already there. So log 1 plus x by a minus 1 by x minus a, you can directly put it, right? But if you want to just make your examiner feel good about you, you can take x by a minus 1 as y. Otherwise log 1 plus theta or log 1 plus say y plus y is equal to 1 only. But we are going to put x by a minus 1 by y, x by a minus 1 equal to y. So if x is tending to a by a is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, so y is tending to 0. Well, y is tending to 0, so limit will change if I write x by a minus 1. So x tends to a is a by a, as I said, 1 minus 1 is 0, so y is tending to 0. Y is tending to 0, and now we are replacing x by a minus 1, x by a minus 1 is 1. And still 1 by a was already there, we won't forget it. So this is log 1 plus y by y, this is going to be 1, and 1 by a is already there, so 1 by a is the final result. 1 by a, okay. So log a plus x minus log a minus x by x. So log p minus log q is log p by q, we know this. So we are going to apply exactly that. So log a plus x by a minus x, and this x will deal separately. Now this is we are adding 1 and we are subtracting 1. We are adding subtracting 1, which we did already. I told you how to do that. So log 1 plus x by x we need to formulate. So you have a plus x by a minus x minus 1. What it will form? A plus x minus a plus x by a minus x. A gets cancelled. You have 2x by a minus x. So log 1 plus 2x by a minus x. So in the denominator, you have 2x by a minus x. So we have 2x by a minus x in the denominator. So 2x by a minus x in the numerator also. And 1 by x was already there, right? 1 by x is already there. What will this be? Log 1 plus theta by theta. Log 1 plus x by x. So you can either do it like that only. It doesn't matter. But still, just to feel that you have done it completely, this will be 2x by a minus x equals y. So when we write this, x is tending to 0. So what will be y? It will be 0. Y will be also tending to 0. So we have limit. Now y we are applying. Y tends to 0. And log 1 plus, now y this will be. Only y this will be. 2x by a minus x is y. So xx you can cancel now. 2 by a minus x, this will be there. Now log 1 plus y by y will be 1. This whole 1. Now taking limit here. It will be x if you put 0. It will be 2 by a minus x. This all will be 1. And this is 2 by a minus x. X is 0. So 2 by a. X is 0. 2 by a will come only. This is going to be a final answer. 2 by a. Question number 21. Log 2 plus x plus log 0.5 divided by x. So you know how to do this now. So what we have? Log a plus log b is what? Log a into b. Log a b. So we will multiply this. Log 2 plus x into 0.5. 0.5 is half. 0.5 is half. So we are writing it as log half into 2 plus x, or you can say 2 plus x divided by 2. Same thing. Okay. Log 2 plus x by half. That is 0.5. Now this will be 2 by 2 plus x by 2, that is 1 plus x by 2, log 1 plus x by 2. So you have x by 2 in the denominator, x is already there, divide by 2, multiply by 2, and just apply the limit. So only 2 is there, otherwise log 1 plus x by 2 by x by 2 is going to be 1. Only 1 by 2 was already there, so 1 by 2 will come. This is your final answer, half. If I would have kept it half outside, only this will remain, otherwise the next term is going to be 1. Now same thing here, log a plus x minus log a by x, this will be log a plus x divided by a, what is this a plus x by a, that is a by a plus x by a, that is 1 plus x by a, so you are log 1 plus x by a, So we already have a x in the denominator. Just divide a and multiply a for the denominator. So I'm taking 1 by a outside, because I know log 1 plus this y by y. If you want to put y as x by a, it's up to you. Otherwise, this log 1 plus a, y by y is going to be 1. 1 by only will remain. Question 23, same thing here. The numbers only have changed. The situation remains the same. The log 3 plus x divided by 3 minus x. And this is 1 plus minus. We are adding and subtracting. 1 plus 1 minus. What this will be? 3 plus x minus 3 plus x divided by 3 minus x. So this 3 gets cancelled. Here 2x by 3 minus x. Log 1 plus 2x divided by 3 minus x. Okay. So in the denominator, what we can have, this is x. So we'll use it. 2 by 3 minus x we are multiplying. So we have to have a 2 by 3 minus x in the numerator also, because 2 by 3 minus x we have introduced by ourselves. X was already there. So if you want to put 2x by 3, you can put 2x by 3 minus x. 2 by 3 minus x you can put as y, but as I said, you don't need to have it. Why? Because log 1 plus y by y, limit, apply limit, this extends to 0, log 1 plus y by y is going to be 1. What will remain? Only 2 by 3 minus x will remain. Log 1 plus y by y, limit extending to 0, right, is going to be 2 by 3 minus x. Only this will remain, this whole will be 1. So 2 by 3 minus x, now apply the limit, x is 0, so 2 by 3 minus 0 is 2 by 3. This is going to be the final answer. Question number 24, 8 raise x minus 2 raise x by x. So this we have already done, this type of question. Question number 5 was there, question number 6, question number 8 was already there. So 8 raise x minus 1 minus 2 raise x plus 1. So we have introduced minus 1 plus 1 by ourselves. X is already there in the denominator, separate it. X raise x minus 8 raise x minus 1 by x, 2 raise x minus 1 by x, and then we have just apply the limits. So 8, limit extends to 0, so a raise x minus 1 by x is going to be log 8. Here it will be log 2, this will be log 8 by 2. So 2 4s are 8, only log 4 will come. Log 4 is the final answer. And this is question number 25. X into 2 raise x minus 1 by 1 minus cos x. So how to deal with this? So 2 raise x minus 1 by x, just have it, 2 raise x minus 1 by x. And you, if you have x in the denominator, you have already paid x. So it has to be x square in the numerator, because x have, you have to multiply in the numerator. So x is there, so you have to have x, x into x is x square. So this x, we have introduced ourselves, x in the numerator, right, x square. So 1 minus cos x there, 1 minus cos x is what? 1 minus cos x is 2 sin square x by 2. It will be 2 sin square x by 2, so 2 sin square x by 2. Okay, now you have 2 sin square x by 2, sin square x by 2 basically we are dealing with. So you need to have a 4 in the numerator, because x square by 4 you need. So you have x square by 4, and you have to have a 4 in the numerator also, just to cancel it out. So 2 just take it out. So now apply the limit separately. See, 2 raise x minus 1 by x is log 2. X by 2 holes, this I am applying the limit. X by 2 whole square divided by sine x by 2 whole square is going to be 1, because sine x by 2 divided by x by 2 is 1, inverted basically. It's limit. It is inverted, but it doesn't matter. And then what you have? 2, 4 and 2, 2 is a 4. So only 2 is remaining, log 2 is there. Now you can take 2 as the power of 2, as I indicated you earlier. Log 2 square is 4, log 4. So this is going to be the answer. Question number 26. So we have here, we have to apply the RF, rationalization factor. So let us multiply the RF of the numerator by numerator with the numerator denominator. So 1 plus x minus 1 multiplied by root 1 plus x plus 1 divided by log 1 plus x, and So how this numerator will solve the denominator? You will just see. 1 plus x plus 1. Now this is a plus b and a minus b formula. A plus b, a minus b. So this is going to be a square minus b square. So 1 plus x minus 1. 1, 1 gets cancelled, x will remain. And since we have log 1 plus x already in the denominator, and we know that log 1 plus x by x is going to be 1, even if it is inverted. And denominator you have 1 plus x plus 1. So just apply the limit. Log 1 plus x by x, this is going to be 1. And how about this one? Log under root 1 plus x, x is 0. We are applying the limit now. Under root 1 plus 1, that is going to be 1 by 2. This is going to be the final answer. Plus x cube by sine cube x. So what you have to do is log 1 plus x cube. So assume it to be y. Just assume. I am just saying that log 1 plus y by y form will, it will come. And you have sine cube x. So you can have a, we are inserting x cube in the denominator. So you have to have, that is y, which I am saying. So you need to have this x cube in the numerator also. So this is just, I am trying to show. Basically, it will be 1 plus x cube by x cube only. So log 1 plus y by y form it will come. So this is log 1 plus y by y form. And here you have this sine x by x whole cube form. Now we know that these two, we know when sine, this limit x is tending to 0. So this is going to be 1. The second one is also going to be 1. So 1 and 1. Both of them is going to be 1. 1 into 1 is going to be 1. Now a to the power cot x minus a cos x by cot x minus a cos x. So we want to make it as a raised x minus 1 by x. So we need a cot, this cot x minus cos x with a. So if we have a raised cot x minus a cos x, so why not to divide this by a cos x, whole by a cos x. So you have a cos x, we are dividing. Since we are dividing, we have to multiply also because we need to cancel it out also. So this is a cos x. So this will be, see, a raise n by a raise m is a raise n minus m. Same we are going to apply it here. So a raise cos x was already there because we multiplied it. A raise cot x minus cos x, and this do that cancelled. Okay. So you have this denominator, you have cot x minus cos x. So you can see that it is clear a raise x minus 1 by x form. But we have to just take a step forward. X is tending to pi by 2. So cot x minus cos x will be tending to what? Because it will be cot pi by 2 minus cos pi by 2. Cot is cos by sine. So cos pi by 2 is 0. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 minus 0. Because cot x is cos pi by 2 by sine pi by 2, that is going to be 0. And this 0 minus 0 is 0. So when x is tending to pi by 2, this, even if you take it as y, the limit y tends to a raise cos x, just take it outside. This is limit y tending to 0 if you take it as y. A raise y minus 1 by y. Just to let you know, you don't have to write this. I'm just saying that if x is tending to pi by 2, this cot x minus cos x will be tending to 0. Okay. So this whole will be what? This is going to be 1. So this is going to be 1, and in the you have a raise cos x remaining. So now apply this limit, x tends to pi by 2. So a raise cos pi by 2, and cos pi by 2 is 0. And what this will be? A raise y minus 1 by y is log a. So log a here, this one, and then you have a raise cos pi by 2, a raise 0 is 1. So 1 into log a. So log a will be the answer. Question number 29. We have limit x tends to 0 e raise x minus 1 by under root 1 minus cos x. So we will multiply it with this RF, rationalization factor. So you have under root 1 minus cos x. So we need to have under root 1 plus cos x and 1 to under root 1 plus cos x, numerator, denominator. Denominator you have a minus b, a plus b. So it will be a square minus b square, 1 square minus sine cos square. 1 minus cos square is sin x. So this you have to be very careful. This sin x is not going to be plus. It can be negative, it can be positive also. Here you will see that the question will turn on its head. So you have sin x, so divided by x and multiplied by x. E raise x minus 1 by x is going to be 1. And this sin x also, sin x by x is also going to be 1. Okay, remember it is mod x. When you remove this root, it will be mod x, minus plus both will come. So under root 1 plus cos x, if you put x as 0, cos 0 is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2, under root 2 it's going to come. So under root 2 is going to come, but the scenario is, the scenario is root 2 is not going to come because we have to take both the cases. One time it is root 2, one time it is minus root 2. Here you will see, oh, the e raise x minus 1 and the sin x by x is pretty clear. But this one, under root 1 minus cos square x, this is very important. 1 minus cos square x, and wherever you remove this under root, you have to include this plus minus sign. That is, you have sin x when you remove the under root, so it has to be plus and minus. So one time you have to take plus, one time you have to take negative. Both you have to take. You cannot just rely on one, because left hand limit, assume it to be left hand limit, right hand limit. So one time you are going to take as minus sin x. There will be no change. See, under root 2 will come in both the times. But one time it is a minus under root 2, one time it is under root 2. See, sin x by x, same thing we are doing. Dividing by x and multiplying by x. And both under root 1 plus cos x only will remain, because e x minus 1 by x and sin x by x is going to be 1. But in the second time, we are going to use positive. First time we have taken negative, that is minus root 2 will come. Second time we are taking it a positive. So positive will, positive sin x will come. So we have this under root 1 plus cos x by sin x by x. So ultimately you have root 2. So minus root 2, root 2 is going to come. So left hand, right hand is not equal. So limit does not exist. The answer of this question is not root 2, but it doesn't exist. Now next is e raise x minus e raise 5 by x minus 5. So similarly with the question we have done earlier, we know the idea now. What do we do? So we have x minus 5, we need x minus 5. So you have e raise x divided by e raise 5 by ourselves. Your e raise 5, so divided by e raise 5. That is a mistake, I'll just change it. And x minus 5 is already there. So what is this going to be? E raise x minus 5, and this gets cancelled because e5 is there. So you have e raise 5 x minus 5 minus 1 by x minus 5. So this is of the form e raise y minus y by y. e raise y minus 1 by y. So if you take x minus 5 as y, what are you going to get? X is tending to 5, so y is tending to 0. So this limit is going to be 0. Y is tending to 0. Okay. So you have limit e raise y minus 1, and e raise 5 was already there. This became 1. So e raise 5 into this 1. So e raise 5 will come. This is question number 31. E raise x plus 2 minus e square by x. So it says straightforward. Write e raise x plus 2 as e raise x dot e raise square, and e raise square is there minus e raise e square. So e square and x minus 1, e square I am taking common. So just apply the limit, e raise x minus 1 by x is going to be, this whole is going to be 1. This is going to be 1, e square remain, e square into 1 is e square. Question 32. So you have e raise cos x minus 1 by cos x. So it's quite straightforward. It's of the form e raise y minus 1 by y. Same thing. So you don't worry about anything, just this is of the already in the form. This is already in the form of the what we needed. So just for the sake of completeness, cos x we are going to put as y, cos x as y, and e raise y minus 1 by y. And when you say x tends to pi by 2, and you know cos pi by 2 is what? Cos 90 is going to be 0. So cos 0 is 1 and cos pi by 2 is 0. So y is cos x. So you can just take it as 1. Now 33, e raise 3 plus x minus sin x minus e cube by x. So e raise 3 plus x is what? E raise 3 dot e raise x, and then your e cube, take it before sin x, minus sin x. Now you have sin x in the denominator. So you can have a sin x for both the terms, because the denominator is same. So you have e raise 3 e raise x minus e raise 3 by x. And you have this one. First, we'll do the first term. e cube erase cube. So erase x minus 1 by x and sin x by x. So you have this as limit, again applying the limit, limit x tends to 0. So this is going to be 1, this is going to 1, e cube is already there. The e cube into 1 minus 1. So you have e cube minus 1 as the answer. Next one is question number 34. So e raise x minus 1 by 2. So how do we do this? We can do it directly. But there is one more method. If you remember, it's very difficult to remember the series. But if you remember the series, you can apply this also directly. E raise x. So one this. So is it possible that we can do it in other way also? Yes, we can do it. Just see. E raise x minus 1. We are taking 1 before this minus x. 1 by 2 is already there. You have e raise x minus 1 minus x. And you have 2 in the denominator. 2, so we have taken it out. So we are dividing by x and multiplying by x by ourselves. So e raise x minus 1 by x. And then you have x by x. Okay. So this is x by 2, just x by 2, keep it outside. So your limit, apply the limit. So limit e raise x minus 1 by x and x by x. So this is x by 2 is already there. So if you see this one, first one, limit e raise x minus 1 by x, applying x tends to 0. And this is going to be e by x by x is 1. So you don't have to apply the limit at all because it's a constant. But still apply it. Sake of completeness, e raise x minus 1 by x is what? 1. And this is also 1. Okay, 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 into, and apply a limit here also, x is 0, x by 2, so 0 by 2, 0. 0 into 0 is 0. So if you see, this is 0. If you have any, you know, some reservations, you can see that e raise x is what? 1, 1 gets cancelled, and x by factorial 1, that also gets cancelled. Okay, so this gets cancelled. Only x square by factorial 2 and remaining term will come. So x square by factorial 2, everything is x here. There is no way to get rid of x. And if you see, x is 0 everywhere. So it's going to be 0. Next one is 35. E raised 3x minus e raised 2x by x. So we can just do it the way we have been doing the other questions. So e raise 3x minus 1, and you have minus e raise 2x. So we are adding 1 and subtracting 1 by ourselves, minus 1 and plus 1, and divide by x because x can be taken for both the denominators. E raise 3x minus 1, and I'm taking minus common. So this will be e raise 2x minus 1. This is minus 1 by x. Okay. So if you see here, this is going to be 3, 3. You need the 3 denominator, you need 2 in the denominator. This is now applying the limit. So e raise 3x minus 1 by 3x is going to be, and e raise 2x minus 1 by 2x is going to be, we know it is going to be 1. E raise y minus 1 by y is 1, right? So this is going to be 1, this is going to be 1, only 3 minus 2 will remain, that is going to be 1. 1 is going to be the answer. Okay, 3 and 2 will remain, other 2 term will be 1. 36. E raise 10x minus 1 by 10x. So this is a straightforward question. E to the power y minus 1 by y form. You know that this is a form which we already know. So either you directly do it, but for the sake of completeness, just say that this tan x is going to be y. Just put it like y. And when x is 0, tan 0 is 0. So y is tending to 0. So limit y tends to 0. So e raise y minus 1 by y is going to be 1. You know this. Now 37, e raise bx minus e raise ax by x. So same question we have just done like this, 35th question. So minus 1 plus 1, and you have e raise bx minus 1 minus e raise ax minus 1 plus 1. Okay, so we have x in the denominator. Now e raise bx minus 1 by x, b, you need bx here, and you need ax also here. Okay. So if you have to multiply b, you have to multiply a. Okay. So now what do you get here? This whole is going to be 1. This whole is going to be 1. and this is going to be minus a. Same way, 3 minus 2, here b minus a. Now erase tan x minus 1 by x. The same thing you are going to do here. This is of the form erase tan x minus 1 by this already we have done. Erase tan x minus 1 by x. So erase tan x minus 1 by x. So just introduce a tan x. So tan x here multiply numerator denominator by tan x. So tan x by x. So this is going to be limit, and this whole is going to be erase y minus 1 by y form. So this is going to be 1, and tan x by x is going to be 1. 1 into 1 is 1 only. So e raise x minus e raise sin x by x minus sin x, limit x tending to 0. So what do we do here? We need x minus sin x in the numerator for the e raise power. So just divide, because x minus sin x, so divide by e raise sin x. Then only you will get e raise x minus sin x. Here also e raise sin x. So if you have divided it, so you have to multiply also e raise sin x. So e raise x minus sin x, this is going to be 1. And I'm taking down denominator x minus sin x. E raise sin x will always be there. Now if you see, this is e raise y minus 1 by y form. This we already seen. You know, if you put x minus sin x as y, so if x is tending to 0, this 0 minus 0 is 0. This is also going to be 0. Okay. So limit y tends to 0, e raise y minus 1 by y. Now applying limit also here, x tending to 0, e raise sin 0 is 1, and e raise to power 1 is, no, sin 0 is 0. So e raise 0 is 1. Anything to the power 0 is 1. Question number 40, e raise 2 plus x minus 9 by x. So e raise 2 dot e raise 3 raise 2 dot 3 raise x minus 9, and 9 I am writing as 3 square, and then you have x in the denominator. Okay, so this is 3 raise x minus 1 by x, applying the limit, and this is going to be what? A raise x minus 1 by x is log a, log 3. 3 square is already there, 9. So either you can take 9 inside, log 3 raised to the power 9, but the answer, just keep it like this, n 9 log 3, this is going to be the answer. Base also you can just mention. A raise x minus a raise minus x by x, same thing we have done, you know, question number 3rd and many questions we have done like this. So this is a raise x, take it in the denominator. A raise x minus 1 by a raise x, and you have x in the denominator, you have 1 in the denominator, so you have just cross multiply a2x minus 1 by ax and x. So this is a raise 2x, so you need a 2, so you need to have a 2 here and multiply it by 2. So this whole is going to be 1, this whole is going to be 1, no, it's a raise, so it will be log a. And what is about this? 2 raise a to the power x, this is log a, and 2 by a raise x. Now applying the limit, so x is 0, so a raise 0 is 1, so 2 will remain, and log a, 2 log a is going to come. Okay, question number 42, x e raise x minus 1 minus cos x. So exactly same question we have done, right? You know, a kind of 29th question was there. And so just you have to do what? This is x e raise x minus 1, and then you have 1 minus cos x. 1 minus cos x is 2 sine square x by 2. 2 sine square x by 2. And this is x is already there. So you can have a x in the denominator for e raise x minus 1. So you have to have a x square here. You have to multiply numerator denominator by x. So this e x minus 1 and x you can take separately. And this is 1 by 2 is already there. I'm taking 2 outside. And you have sin square x by 2. You have x square by 2. And you can multiply numerator denominator by 4, because x by 2 whole square you need. So e raise x minus 1 by x is 1. This is sin x by 2 whole square. So what is remaining here? 4 and 2. So 4 divided by 2 you are going to get. And 4 divided by 2 is what? 2 to the 4. 2 is the answer. Question number 43. 2 raised minus cos x minus 1 by x into x minus pi by 2. So, how do we do this? First, let us get rid of this minus cos x. X minus pi by 2 is in the denominator. We just need to remove this 2 raised minus cos x. So, how do we do this? Cos x, we are going to write sin pi by 2 minus x, sin 90 minus theta. So, sin 90 minus theta is cos theta. So, this is cos x. So, cos x can be written as sin pi by 2 minus x. Sin 90 minus theta is cos theta. So, minus is already there. You know that sin minus theta is minus sin theta. Okay, sin minus theta is minus sin theta. So, you can take negative inside. When you have negative inside, it will be sin minus theta is minus sin theta, as I just suggested. So, this you can take inside. So, when you take minus inside, it will be sin x minus pi by 2. This is sin x minus pi by 2, right? So, you have 2 rays and sin x minus pi by 2, okay? You have a minus 1 as well, minus 1. Then, denominator you have this x and x minus pi by 2. X minus pi by 2. X is already there, okay? Remember, x into pi by 2. So, I'll use this x later on. So, this is still we need sin here. Why? Because this will not solve our purpose. So, we are introducing sin x minus pi by 2 and sin x minus pi by 2. This is going to be log 2. See, 2 raise sin, 2 raise whatever minus 1 by whatever. That is 2 raise y minus 1 by y is going to be log 2. So, I am taking y, as I said, 2 by y minus 1 by y is going to be 1. Is going to be what? Is going to be log 2. Is going to be log 2. So, this is log 2, right? So, log 2 here. This is done. Now, what is remaining? Sin x minus pi by 2. Sin x minus pi by 2. And we already have a x minus pi by 2 in the denominator because we introduced it. It was already there. We didn't introduce it. So, you have sin, this is x minus pi by 2. This is also going to give you what? 1. So, sin x minus pi by 2 and sin x minus pi by 2 by x minus pi by 2 is going to be 1. So, our thing are solved. We have taken the identities. So, 2 raised y minus 1 by y is log 2. The sin x minus pi by 2, x minus pi by 2 is going to be 1. Right? So, now you have a x in the denominator. Log 2 is done. Only x is in the denominator, other things are being done, taken care. Okay, so now see here. So, this x we are going to employ and we are going to apply the limits here. X is tending to pi by 2. So, x is pi by 2. So, just put x as pi by 2. So, pi by 2 is in the denominator, so 2 will go in the numerator. So, log 2 pi, 2 will go in the numerator. So, 2 log 2 by pi. So, this is going to be the final answer. So, this is all about this exercise. Thank you so much and take care of yourself.